and the perfect music mix. Neil Diamond there and Mr. Bojangles. And I'm going to play that especially for Marion Tivnan in Durley Park, and Marion is celebrating her birthday today. Happy birthday, and that comes in to you from Mrs. O'D and all the family, and hoping you'll enjoy your day. Now, just to mention that Donegal County Council wish to inform motorists that roadworks will commence on Thursday the 9th of September on the Ardahi to Ardra Road. The road will be closed Monday to Friday and reopened at weekends. Please use other routes, the M56 or the R262. Donegal County Council apologise for any inconvenience caused, and if you have any queries, you can contact 07497 24400. That's 07497 24400. Now, it is Wednesday morning, and that means we're in the company of Gabriel McSharry, medical herbalist and nutritionist. And if you have any questions for Gabriel, you can send them in to us now by text to 083 3500 530. And Craig is taking your calls on 0818 365 500. Now, Gabriel, this listener wants to know, what can they do to help the 4-year-old who often suffers from chesty coughs?
Yeah, herbs are great for a chesty cough, especially in kids. I'd use a herbal formula containing a certain class of herbs, respiratory tonics, immune stimulants, and expectorants. Expectorants are, it depends too on the cough. You know, we vary what herbs we use, but the expectorants kind of bring up mucus, if there's mucus, or if it's non-productive. Like if the cough doesn't bring up any sputum, then you'd use different ones. But
is that what you hear people saying? Is it a dry cough, or is it a dry cough where you're not bringing up anything? Or
yes, yeah, or what we'd also call it, a non-productive cough. And it's important, really. Well, it's important for a medical herbalist because we choose different herbs because to work differently. But as well too, it can give you an indication whether there's an infection by the sputum and the colour of the sputum and so on. So we'd always ask into a few more questions about just the cough, you know. If the recurrent, well, you know, they're the class of herbs I'd use. Certain types of herbs: elecampane, solidago, thymus, astragalus, lobelia, lovage, licorice. These are all respiratory tonics, expectorants, and good for the immune system as well. A formula of that. I have, I can let her know about a homemade cough syrup that's a traditional one. It's made from onion juice and honey.
Onion juice?
Yeah. And honey, and
it's tasteful.
Yeah, well, it's actually not bad, you know. Here's how you do it, and you should really give it a go. Everyone should give this a go coming into the winter now, or into the weather is getting worse, and have it on hand if they do get a sore throat or a wheeze or a cough or any kind of respiratory obstruction. You get an onion and you slice it and you put it into, a 1-pound honey jar that's maybe a quarter full of honey.
Okay.
And with a lid, and you cover it, and you leave it for a couple of days and maybe shake it in between after a day. And after a couple of days, then you strain off the honey. You'll see it's kind of liquefied a bit, you know. So if the honey was thick, it's gone more liquid. You just take it by the spoonful. So a spoonful every couple of hours if you have a cough or this wheezing and so on. And so it does a number of things. It's expectorant, but it's also antimicrobial, antibacterial. And it doesn't actually taste too bad.
it doesn't sound great, but we trust you that it doesn't taste too bad.
Honey is quite sweet, and then the onion then would be... onion is onion, you know. It's high in sulfur and so on. But actually the mix isn't too bad, you know. There's also decongestant herbal oils, which could be good here for anyone who's chesty, children or with coughs. Albus oil, thyme, eucalyptus, T3, all these essential oils, you could have them near their bed or in a diffuser in the corner of the room, or And they can be helpful as well.
Okay. Now, this listener says their mother has a lot of trapped wind. She's bloated. She hates going out in public because of this problem, and we can all understand why. She's taking medication for other health problems. Is there anything that she can do?
Right. Again, a full case history, very helpful. But any kind of bloating, flatulence, wind, there's always dysbiosis there. What that is an imbalance in the microorganisms in the gut. And it's generally the gas caused by these microorganisms, say the bad guys, so generally via a fermentation process. And this gas then kind of swells up the abdomen. And in some women that can look, 6 months pregnant, and, you know, it can be quite profound. And with that, you get discomfort. Also, there's a strong connection between the gut and the brain. And we know this, the certain neurotransmitters that we produce in the gut. So with a lot of gut ailments, it can bring on neurological ails as well, like, people get embarrassed, but they might get hyper-embarrassed and afraid to go out and this type of thing, and just feel unwell. Some people get a little bit depressed. I mean, it's a common thing in conditions like IBS, you know, this bloating, flatulence, and sometimes altered bowel function, diarrhea, constipation, and so on. So a few things she could do. Probiotics are great. So a good quality probiotic, so a multiple strain. Now, probiotics are microorganisms, but they're good guys, we'll say. And so if you take them on a daily basis, it'll be helpful. Then I use certain herbs which suppress or kill bad guys, so any kind of candida or yeast or unfavourable microorganisms in the gut, Helicobacter pylori, Campylobacter, Jeannie, all these that are the most common ones. And we've herbs specific that will knock them out, and they're good to put in there. Some digestive tonics in general. I mentioned one before, Iberogast. It's a clinically proven herbal medicine. It's 12 herbs. I make it at the clinic, but it's 12 herbs, and it's used for the symptoms of, we'll say, IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, which include this bloating and flatulence. Now, diet is very important. Like all these things I've just mentioned are aids. But to get down to the fix, diet is very important. So things that will make it worse are high sugar diets, high alcohol, anything that ferments, vinegar, malt, things like this. So you got to watch them. And then obviously if there's a good supply of nutritious food going in all the time, then over time things will improve. So it's kind of an overall thing. And in the meantime, she has to cut out things as well that suppress good bacteria in the gut. So, if you think about it, pesticides, herbicides, all these things that could be sprayed on foods. Like, our gut microflora are important to us, and they're very much part of our immune function. So things we spray on foods are to kill these microorganisms. Kill them on the foods when they grow, but you know, as we consume them, they also have an adverse effect in the gut. So there's other things out there, fluoride, chloride, things that are in our environments that also affect our gut microflora, hormones, certain medication. Now, she did mention she was on medication, but oral contraceptive pill, antibiotics, and certain hormone therapy, I'm aware, definitely changed the gut microflora, but there's a few others as well. So it's an overall approach, really.
So just the diet again, it comes into this quite often. Now, this listener has a reoccurring rash on their face. They use cream suitable to sensitive skin. What could be causing it?
Well, all skin rashes can be caused by foods a person is sensitive to. So it's important to keep that in mind. It could be the foods that they're eating. Since it's on the face, though, maybe it's something other than a food source, and it could be like a contact allergy. So certain things to keep in mind, makeup, you know, whatever, highlighters and makeup removers, cleansers, toners, all these things that
your
are
foundation,
chemical.
Foundation, your eyeshadow. Yeah.
You know better than me.
I
help
you out there.
But all these things, you know, like it amazes me sometimes, you know, there's a lot of chemicals there, and then you have to use chemical stuff to get it off at night too, you know. Mm. So that's a lot of stuff going on. But perfumes, hair dye, if you have long hair and it could be touching the face, shampoo, soaps, even clothes, you know, that you could be washing it in certain chemical detergents and that'll be on your collar and that might touch the skin or a scarf or and so on. So things to be aware of that they could be causing it. And things to note, the skin is actually self-cleansing. And here's the thing about using so much stuff on the face. And specifically, you know, people with kind of blackheads or comedones, as they're called in medicine, and acne and stuff, they tend to start rush out and use an awful lot of stuff to kind of clean down the face and scrub it with all sorts of chemicals. But in essence, the skin is self-cleansing, and what you really need to focus on is getting the internal environment right. So good oils in the diet, very important for healthy skin. And you know, the healthy oils in the skin get stripped off by these cosmetics and stuff. So essential fatty acids, omega 3, 6, 9, 3 is more important. 6 and 9 you'd probably be getting enough of in the diet. But omega 3s, you're looking at fatty fish or fish oils, cod liver oil. Evening primrose oil is a good oil for skin and skin conditions. Borage oil and flax oil, flaxseed oil. So all them are really good oils in general for the skin. And I suppose that's kind of an aside, and they may not have any bearing on the rash at all, but just to put them out there. But in general, you know, I'd need to know full diet and case history and that to, and maybe see the rash. You know, is it kind of more like a nettle rash, like hives? Urticaria, or is it a more kind of small red marks, or if it's just a big red patch, you know, all these can kind of tell a story too.
Okay, right, we have a quick break to take. Keep your questions coming in to us to 083 3500 530, which is text, and you can call us at 0818 365 500. Rejoin us after the short break.
Ocean FM. Tour de Strand face Ballymoe in the first of this weekend's Sligo Senior Football Championship semi-finals at 6:15. Ocean FM will have full commentary from Markovic Park, with thanks to Flynn's Bar Tour de Strand, home to live trad every Wednesday and music every weekend. Both sides are undefeated in Championship 2010. Tour de Strand are going for two in a row and will face their toughest test yet against a Ballymote side under Eugene McHale, contesting their first senior football semi-final since 1966. So make sure to join Ocean FM this Saturday evening for all the action as Tour de Strand take on Ballymote, thanks to Flynn's Bar, Tour de Strand's number one supporter, on the Northwest's Ocean FM.
Ocean FM.
Looking for car insurance without checking out Aviva is like looking for your spare tire without checking the boot. So if you need car insurance, now is the time to contact Aviva. You'll get a price you'll like and a policy you'll love. And if you've passed your driving test in the last 5 years, you can save up to 40% just for passing Ignition, our 1 hour safe driving assessment. You also get loads of great benefits like breakdown, windscreen and personal belongings cover. To arrange your policy today, log on to aviva.ie or call us on 1890 33 22 11. Aviva, looking out for you. Aviva Insurance Europe PLC is regulated by the financial regulator. Terms and conditions apply. See aviva.ie for details. Cover available on comprehensive motor care and motor choice policies only. For Ignition, you must drive a car of 1600cc or less.
Going north? Why not call at Belcoo Pharmacy? New range of handbags, sunglasses, watches and jewellery now in stock. Prices worth stopping for. Only at Belco Pharmacy.
John Ward Sligo Office Supplies here, inviting you to our new business premises and retail outlet at Finislin Road, Sligo. Call us on 071 91 46226 or visit our online catalogue, sligooffice supplies.ie. We have an in-store draw this month for a Noki laser printer. For further details, drop into our new premises.
Plan your kids' dinners with top quality award-winning food from the Food Centre Cleaver Business Park, Sligo. Award-winning food at fantastic prices from the Food Centre Cleaver Business Park, Sligo. It's all about quality.
Right now at Tubs and Tiles in their unbeatable bathroom sale, get amazing bathroom packages at unbelievable prices. Because at the Tubs and Tiles unbeatable bathroom sale, you'll find a complete package with everything you need for your dream bathroom, including tiles, from just €989. Tubs and Tiles unbeatable bathroom sale, now on. Terms and conditions apply while stocks last.
The Donegal Post newspaper is recruiting for the position of editor. The ideal candidate will have a proven track record and will be familiar with the region. The successful candidate will be an energetic, innovative leader who will see the Donegal Post continue to grow from strength to strength. The closing date for applications is the 15th of September. Send your CV to Sinead at letterkennypost.com. That's Sinead at letterkennypost.com.
Thursday 8th. Dear Diary, Mark's getting a string for Friday. He always sorts us out. Think he likes me, really, but Teen's the only guy for me. Saturday 10th, been sick all day, but it was worth it. Mark got us all vodka, we were out of it. Dean even smiled at me. Me! Don't know how I got home, but who cares?
We're not always aware of what's going on in a child's life, but we can't ignore that more and more children are drinking alcohol. The time to do something is before it becomes a problem. Visit yourdrinking.ie from the HSE.
To have your say, call the Northwest Today comment line on 0818 365 500. Text your comment to 083 3500 530.
And you're very welcome back to the programme. We are in the company of Gabriel McSharry, medical herbalist and nutritionist. Now, listeners wanting you to repeat your thoughts on juices such as orange juice, apple juice, etc. That people are inclined to give to children. I suppose adults as well drink them.
Yeah. I'd watch fruit juice because it's very high in sugar. And it's, you know, it's natural sugar, but it's a high amount of sugar to take in all at once. So eat the fruit by all means, but drinking a lot of the juice is not healthy in my opinion, because it's a concentrated form of fruit sugar. So an example I give, you'd never really sit down and eat seven oranges in one go, or seven apples, say. But it's easy enough to drink the equivalent in juice format, the sugar component. So, I mean, with that, if you're eating the whole fruit, you're getting fibre and certain proteins and stuff as well. And it's just to be aware of it. And, you know, if you want to have a small bit, a little bit of apple juice in a glass of water can kind of taste up the water. And it's much better than things like cordial you know, my wadi, diluted stuff. You know, some parents would say the kids won't drink it unless there's a bit of something in it. And then put a little bit of juice in, but just juice on its own, watch, you know. And be wary, like, you know, be wary of children who consume a lot of fruit juice, you know. And some parents think, you know, the diet's good because, you know, they don't eat sweets or junk food. Now, you know, you don't need me to say that junk food and sweets are bad in general. But some parents think that the kids' diet's good, yet it may not be. And if they... so, beware of a poor diet in disguise, maybe. Like, does your child eat nothing but, you know, breads, cereals, say rice cakes, noodles, spuds, chips... waffles, stuff, battered stuff, you know, batter on them, and loves red sauce, brown sauce or gravy, say, biscuits, fruit juice, Ribena, and kind of, we'll say, sweet things like sweet yogurt or something. Now, all them, to some people or some parents, they might think, oh, well, the diet's quite good, you know, he eats lots of all them. But in general, it's not. If that's all he eats, you know, some kids love all this stuff and kind of crave this stuff, but they avoid kind of meat and eggs and cheese and veggies. you know, in my opinion, it's not a good diet, you know. It's mm-hmm. it's kind of what I'd call a carb junkie, you know, so a lot of carbohydrates. And but generally, kids who eat a lot of this also go mad for sweets as well, you know.
Okay, so it's just basically they're high in sugar, but there should be fresh fruit and vegetables.
Well, they all turn, like all that I mentioned there, they all turn to sugar. And, you know, the odd time is part of a balanced diet, okay, but sometimes just parents think, oh, the kid is great. He eats loads of spuds and gravy, say, you know, but he doesn't touch the meat. But at least he's eating the spuds and gravy, you know. Mm. And he has his Weetabix and, you know, he'd eat a biscuit or he drinks a bit of juice. You know, but all these things in isolation aren't good, you know, because they all turn to sugar. And okay. Even though they're not sweets,
they're still sugary.
Yes.
Okay, a 40-year-old woman who has a good diet, but now her metabolism has slowed down and she's put on weight. What can she do? She has never been over 10.5 stone in weight.
Yeah, it seems like it's time for a rehaul of diet and lifestyle, maybe. You know, maybe she can't burn the candle at both ends any longer type of thing, you know. So maybe a certain lifestyle that was okay until now, she's just not able to do the same yet. She's trying to do the same yet. It's taken its toll by maybe slowing down the body or she's putting on weight and so on. So, like, a few questions to her. Is, you know, are you sleeping enough? Are you exercising enough? Did you by any chance have a kid recently or a few kids? Or have you got a promotion? You know, have you, you know, at 40 you may have just got a promotion and you've taken on a lot more responsibility. And without even being aware, you're actually doing a lot more work and maybe sleeping less. And these are things that she may not have took into account, that, you know, she's slowing down, she's not able for or whatever. But in general, it sounds like it's a good time to maybe see a nutritionist, get an overhaul of diet and see, and lifestyle. Mm-hmm. You know, maybe she just needs someone to tell her what she wants to hear. To get her to kickstart her off.
Do you not realise life begins at 40? isn't that what they say?
That's what they say, yeah. But, you know, that'd be my opinion on it. Just it could be time to kind of, for a bit of a change.
Okay, just look at the diet and the exercise and what she is actually doing in her life.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay, I have a condition. I'm told it's a type of herpes where the corners of the mouth crack, become very red and unsightly. I've tried lots of remedies with lemon balm, astragalus tea, tea tree oil. None of them seem to work. Can you recommend anything?
It sounds like angular stomatitis is the name, where you get this kind of redness in the corner of the mouth. That, as far as I know, isn't a virus, but herpes is. So if you had the diagnosis of herpes and you were doing some of the right things naturally, like lemon balm, not as a tea now, but as an essential oil topically, is antiviral. Tea tree is antiviral. Astragalus is good for the immune system, and that can be helpful. However, you've tried these nothing's happened. So, again, you know, make sure, like with anything kind of ulceration in the mouth or in the tongue or on the lips, in the corners, it could be an insight into overall digestion. Maybe there's some sort of digestive ailment there. And, you know, what's your digestion like? Do you get much bloating, flatulence, altered bowel function and so on? So the tongue and the mouth is an insight into the overall digestive tract, which runs from the mouth to the anus. It's worth making note of that. And diet and stuff is very important. And what I mentioned earlier on, the whole probiotics and the microorganisms, getting them right. Specifically for herpes, a few things you might want to try. St. John's wort oil, an oil extraction topically, is good for envelope viruses, which are the herpes virus. Lemon balm essential oil, topically. Immune, keep going with the immune stimulants like astragalus, echinacea, internally.
Okay. I get foot cramps where my toes all turn inwards. What can I do? I can feel the pain of that.
Yeah. Well, with recurrent cramps, it's important to make sure you have enough minerals and trace elements in the diet. So things like magnesium in a supplement form might be helpful. You could try that. That'd be something just straight off. But I'd look into, do you actively avoid salt as part of a healthy regime? And if so, then maybe you should start adding salt, but not table salt. So table salt, I think I mentioned this before a few times, but table salt is a poor product in my opinion. But unrefined sea salt isn't. It's actually healthy for the body. It has 82 minerals and trace elements, and these things are very important, especially for people with who get cramps or spasms recurrent. So these things could be rectified by the right electrolytes, and unrefined sea salt has these minerals, trace elements in it, and I'd encourage you to add that to your food. This is, I guess, so long as you don't have severe cardiovascular disease and severe hypertension or something like that. So table salt, on the other hand, has these minerals and trace elements stripped out of it, and they bleach it white and they add anti-caking agent and so on, and it's a really poor product, in my opinion. So that's a few things they can try.
Okay, lots of people wondering how long your cough bottle lasts if you make it up.
Yeah, well, I mean, you can make up more of it, but as I say, if it's a quarter of a pound jar of honey, you have about a quarter pound of liquid, and you take it in teaspoon doses every hour or so while you have the flu or any kind of cough or sore throat and stuff. You could just, if you wanted to, you could double or quadruple the ingredients I told you. You know, maybe use two onions. I will say, I don't think I said, but use good onions and good honey. You know, like when you're using foods and stuff as medicine, I'd get good quality, possibly organic onions, and a good quality unheated honey, so raw honey. And it's something you can take ongoing, you know. And I think everyone should have it in the kitchen and the press, you know.
Okay, Manuka honey, how do we know what strength to take for a cold or whatever sickness?
I don't know what, if you're have a really bad cold, should you take a high strength? But the strength system is based on certain constituents in it, and Manuka honey is a good honey. And I think the higher the strength, the more powerful it is. However, I do think that a good quality raw honey, when I mean raw, there's a number of ways of taking the honey out of the hive. And to get more yield of honey, they heat the hive. It's heated up. And when the honey is heated up, or when they heat it up, when they mix it, so they might blend, say, a batch of honey from China with a batch of honey from Finland, we'd say. And a honey company could mix that up at high temperature and then put it all into the jars. When you heat it over 40 degrees, you destroy certain enzymes in it. And it's unfortunate because it's what, in my opinion, is a good part of the honey. So if someone uses an expeller or a centrifuge or something to get the honey out of the hive, then they don't heat it up, and therefore that's a good honey. So therefore we call that a raw honey. Now, it's written on the label. People who produce raw honeys would say honey obtained purely by mechanical means or something like that, and look for that on the label. Or organic tends to be of good quality honey, and they can be cheaper than Manuka. Manuka is kind of, it comes from New Zealand and so on, but maybe we get one that's closer and cheaper and as good. And then they have it in certain strengths. So if there's a good benefit of Manuka, is it is quantified and standardized to a strength system, and you know kind of what you're getting. See how it goes. As far as I'm aware, the higher strength, the more powerful the honey is.
Okay. Someone just texts in to say a pinch of salt in your mouth will take a cramp away in seconds. Never heard tell of that.
Yeah, well, back to what I was saying with the electrolytes. If, for instance, you, you know, and I actually see this a lot. So some people says, right, this is it. I'm going to turn over a new healthy leaf. And so I'm going to give up all processed foods. And I'm going to eat right. And I'm going to start down the gym. Right. It's yes. Usually the
all
January,
the January
February kind of thing. Now, what happens is, so to give up processed food, great. I highly encourage it. These things are all laden with this processed table salts. And then they start exercising, which is great. I highly encourage it. So they're sweating more. So they're losing salts, you know, from the body. So there might be an imbalance in electrolytes. So you really need to supplement with salt if you've got it. If you eat no processed foods, which is great, you know, that's the way to be, you should supplement with salt. And good quality, unrefined sea salt. There's one called Selmarin the Atlantic. So marine salt of the Atlantic. It's harvested off France. And you can get that in health food stores. And it's damp and it's a little darkish. You know, it's kind of greyish. It's not brilliant white. And that's the minerals and trace elements. And there's potassium and there's all sorts of electrolytes. So for some people who are deficient in these electrolytes, they'll go into cramp. And you see it like with a lot of marathon runners and triathletes and stuff. Nearly all the time someone will go into cramp or spasm. And in that instance, some salt or saline water can actually relieve it straight away. And it's just replacing these electrolytes. And I mean, they're important for heart function. You know, the heart is a muscle. Mm-hmm. It's probably one of us, it's our most active muscle, I think, in the body. It's beating so much non-stop, 24/7, maybe 60, 70 times a minute. And, you know, it needs these electrolytes too. And, you know, they can go in, it can go into spasm and you can get arrhythmia and stuff like that as well, you know. So a lack of or an over consumption of these electrolytes. So,
okay.
Salt is very important. We used to fight wars over it. You know, salary, the word comes from, you used to get paid your wages in salt. But again, it was unrefined sea salt,
okay.
Not this table salt that's on everyone's table.
That's
nearly
on everyone's table. Okay, now we've lots of people looking for your cough remedy again. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a quick break and you can give out your remedy when we come back and have a pen and paper ready. And just after this break, Gabriel will give out his cough remedy.
Ocean FM. Did you know that the average person spends a whopping 32% of their day listening to the radio? Radio is the strongest performing medium in the morning, right up to mid-afternoon. It's business as usual for our listeners. They tune in every day. What would you like to say to them about your business? Find out what we can do for you. Contact Ocean FM now on 071-911-8100 and make radio work for you.
100% guaranteed Irish. Ocean FM.
Would you like to own your own luxury home next to the coast with stunning views? Well, why not pay a visit to Aylesbury Park, Strandhill Road, Sligo? Make your dream a reality. Amazing homes at affordable prices with a high-spec finish throughout. Another exclusive development by McMenamin Homes, one of the longest established building firms in the Northwest. To view, contact McMenamin Homes on 086-353-3388. That's 086-353-3388.
Ideas. They're what business is all about. Every company is built on an idea, and to grow, it needs fresh ideas. Like getting your office landline, broadband and mobile together for just $49.99 a month. It's just one bright idea from O2 that means more value and more certainty for you. So call 1-800-2000-02 or visit o2.ie/totalbusiness for more. Because sometimes an idea, no matter how big or small, is all your business needs. O2. Together is better. Applies to O2 Total Business 3 megabyte price plan. See O2.ie for terms.
The Black Cat Cove Balik, Thursday traditional session. All musicians welcome. And the start of dancing lessons. Friday night live music with Brendan Rooney. Saturday it's Stevie B. Sunday lunch served all day at the Black Cat Cove Balik.
Tiles Direct and Bathroom Centre, Ross Nowler Road, Valley Shannon. Your number one retailer in the Northwest. Drop into their new refurbished showroom, complete with various wet room features. Amazing discounts throughout on tiles, timber flooring, and sanitary ware. experts also in supply and fit 3cm granite. That's Tiles Direct and Bathroom Centre, Rosnola Road, Ballyshannon. 071-9852-956.
John B. Keane's classic folk play, Sharon's Grave, will be staged by Colour Dramatic Society at the Hawkswell Theatre, Sligo, from Wednesday the 15th to Saturday the 18th of September, starting at 8pm. For tickets, book now, Hawkswell Theatre, 071-91-61526. Don't miss it.
Picaleri Furniture, Lacken and Escrome. Over 3,000 square feet of kitchen and bedroom furniture on display in their exclusive showrooms. Stroll around their fabulous displays. Kitchens that inspire you day and night. Picaleri Furniture, Lacken and Escrome, 096-36524.
At Super Value, we've got the best of back-to-school value, like selected Super Value quality Irish meat, any 3 for €10. Selected fresh fruit and veg, any 3 for €4. And Huggies Super Dry Mega Box range, only €16. Super Value. Real food, real people.
EJ Menswear end of season clear out is now on. All EJ stock is reduced by 50% or more, with loads of extra special bargains in store. EJ Menswear half price sale now on.
More music variety and good conversation. Niall Delaney. Ocean.
And you're very welcome back to the programme. We are in the company of Gabriel McSherry, medical herbalist and nutritionist. Now, just before we get our cough remedy, listener wants to know what ginkgo is for and what's it good for?
Well, ginkgo biloba is a herb, and it's, I suppose, a circulatory stimulant, but it's many things. It's probably one of the most well-researched herbal medicine. There's a myriad of clinical trials published on it, all showing quite good efficacy for things like circulation. Specifically, it improves cerebral circulation, so circulation to the brain, and with that it can improve cognitive function, memory, prevention and a treatment for Alzheimer's and dementia. And that's very important, because there's not much there in even the conventional realm for that, so it's quite unique that way. But it's very high in antioxidants. It's a good tonic for the arteries and the vessels, so for the vascular system, and it can be good for things like the eyes as well. But again, back to it's what we call antiplatelet aggregating factor. That's the specific thing it does. So not available over the counter in the south of Ireland. I, as a medical herbalist, can prescribe it, so people can give me a call and talk to me about it. But it's a really good, safe herbal medicine. The reason not available over the counter is it can interact with blood thinners. So is on warfarin or
aspirin or something like that,
blood thinners, then it'll be contraindicated, and so that's why. But if used correctly, it's a very safe and effective herbal medicine.
Okay, strontium ranelet, what's that?
Yeah, so strontium is, and this actually ties in with what we were saying about salt. The natural place where we get salt or strontium in the diet is in unrefined sea salt, but it's not in refined salt. So there you go. Strontium is important for the health of your bones. So anyone with osteopenia, osteoporosis, I think a strontium supplement can be important, so long as you have no decreased kidney function or damage. Now, strontium isn't available over the counter in Ireland. It's available on prescription by your GP. I think it's called Protolose or Proteolase or something like that. Interestingly, though, it is available over the counter in the States. So, you can go into any vitamin store in the States and buy it. Mm-hmm. There's a number of different forms. Strontium ranelate is the one, I think, on prescription here. The strontium picinolate. There's a few different forms, but it's definitely for any one with osteopenia, osteoporosis. It's important to add to the, in my opinion, to add to the overall treatment protocol.
Okay, now give out that what's going to become your famous cough fixture.
Well, I can't take credit for it. It is actually an old homemade formula for as a cough syrup. But so you get an onion, medium sized onion, and you slice it up and you put it into about a pound sized honey jar or jar, quarter fill, and you can quarter fill it with honey. So you immerse the onion pretty much with the honey, and give it a shake and put it in a cupboard, and leave it for a day, take it out, give it a shake and leave it for another day, and then take it out and strain off the liquid. So the honey and the honey is will absorb the onion juice, and so you throw away that what's left over, you know, the bits of onion and that, and what you have is a liquid that can there's antimicrobial. It does a number of different things, specifically for colds, and that it can coat the lining of the upper respiratory tract and so on. So if a dry cough and that, it can ease that a bit on the mucous membranes. And it's something that kids don't mind taking. Like, you know, you might think onion juice, right? Yeah, that's crazy. But it's like if it just waters down the honey, and the honey still holds some of its sweetness. So you take it by the teaspoon, a teaspoonful every maybe hour, every couple of hours, as part of a regime while, you know, bed rest and all the other things. I sometimes put in herbs in there as well, a tincture of thyme or elecampane or inula. I get people to put it into their honey mix, you know, and even some herbalists make cough syrup themselves out of honey with the herbs, and sometimes might have allium juice or onion juice in there, you know.
Okay. Is salt with iodine in it good or bad for you?
Yeah, so, I mean, salt with iodine is a processed salt where they add iodine. And, I guess if you're deficient in iodine, then it's a source of iodine. I know better sources, but back to the unrefined sea salt. I think definitely if you're to use salt, use unrefined sea salt, and seek out, like, you know, salt. All salt is from the sea. All salt is sea salt. So people have these weird and wonderful dispensers of salt. You grind them and they're in rock format, but they could be still processed salt, just put into rocks and that. So as I said, the salt I recommended is actually a little bit of a grey tinge to it. It's damp, and it's full of minerals and trace elements, and it's just, as far as I know, evaporated seawater from off the coast of Brittany, where they have these salt pans for a long time, and it contains 82 minerals and trace elements.
Okay. Now, always tired and think I may be anemic. How would I know?
Go to your GP, get a blood test, and check your ferritin levels, or iron levels. And if they're low, you're anemic.
Okay. Is there any special kind of honey for your cough mixture?
Yeah, well, again, when we were talking about honey, the likes of a raw honey is better than the likes of some of the, well, I won't mention brands, but read the
jars.
Read the labels of some of the popular ones in Ireland. The poor honeys, you know, it'll say it's a blend of honey from EU and China, you know. But get one that's not heated up. Manuka is good. I have my own preference because I like certain honeys, you know, from bees that have fed off a certain plant, we'll say. They'll have a different taste than honey, you know. And the one I have kind of tastes toffee-ish, and that's the one I use. Like, but, you know, someone else might like a different one. So a good quality honey and good quality onion
is
the way to go, yeah.
Okay, Gabriel, we have a lot of questions, and I tell you, we could be here for another hour or two. So, but what we'll do is we'll start with those questions next week. And thanks to our listeners who have taken the time to send them in. But some of the I suppose advice takes a little bit longer than some of the quick fire questions that we get in as well. So we'll certainly get to those questions that we have left over. If our listeners would like to contact you,
they can ring 071 91 42940.
Okay. Gabriel McSharry, medical herbalist and nutritionist. Thanks for joining us in the studio this morning. And of course, you're back with us again just after 11 o'clock next week. And don't forget, any questions that you have sent in that we haven't been able to get to this morning, we'll certainly start off with those next week, as we do every week.